I'm Christine.
And life is all about facing your fears, is it not?
There's things, you're afraid of them, you do them, you come out, you grow.
And it's time for me to face this fear that I've been holding on to since last November, which is editing the video I got to make with Chad Michael Murray. Maybe you know him from Freaky Friday, or One Tree Hill, or Cinderella Story. Yes, Chad Michael Murray.
I know, why am I afraid of it?
Well, let me tell you. The latest and greatest of my most embarrassing moments that just made me want to burrow in a hole and die happened right at the beginning of this video.
Right at the beginning!
We were there to help hype Chad's new book, American Drifter. I had a really fun video planned with all these random questions. I'm in this room, sitting next to Chad Michael Murray, heartthrob of my childhood, and the guy who plays Tristan on Gilmore Girls, the show I absolutely love and adore and rewatch all the time. Did I mention I'm in the room, sitting next to Chad Michael Murray? And like right across from me is Natasha, and there's all these other people, like their crew and Chad's wife and his co-author. I pick up the book and I'm like, Chad's new book, American Drifter by Chad Michael Murray and Lauren Graham. That's what I said. Now, maybe nothing's happening in your mind yet, because maybe you haven't had a good enough look at this cover. But the co-author is Heather Graham.
Heather Graham.
I said Lauren Graham,
the woman who plays Lorelai Gilmore
on Gilmore Girls. Okay? Heather is literally sitting right over there. I'm here to promote her and Chad's book, and I said, Lauren Graham, instead of Heather Graham. From that moment on, I was just like a melted blob of stuttering. I don't even know what happened. It was just a blur, okay? I had all these fun questions planned and I did them, but my chest was collapsing in on itself because I said the wrong name, okay? It was like Ross at the altar getting married to Emily. That's what I felt like, okay? I was just, this is so horrible. I kept like trying to ease my anxiety by making jokes about it, and like it just wasn't working. I was like, I'm just reminding everyone that this happened. Why am I doing this? But I just kept doing it. I was anxious for the rest of the day. I said I'm sorry like a thousand times to Heather afterwards. She was really cool about it, but like, it never will be better because it happened. I ruined it. So I haven't touched the footage because I am very, very afraid, but today I'm doing it. Face your fears. So here it is. Cringe Fest 2017 for Christine. Don't judge me too harshly because I am judging myself so hard.
Hello, I am here today with special author, also actor, guest, Chad Michael Murray.
Hey y'all, how is everyone?
And Chad has a book that just came out that he co-wrote with Lauren Graham and Heather Graham. Oh my God, why did I just say Lauren Graham? Has a book out called American Drifter that just came out with Heather Graham.
Yeah, I've been around for 18 years.
Wow. Yeah.
And this is the one thing I'm most proud of right now.
That's fantastic.
As far as work-wise, I'm so proud of it. To take a vision, and when it comes down and it's on the page, and it's so vivid and it's so there and it's so clear and it comes out as you had dreamed and as you had hoped, it doesn't always happen that way.
It's like a romantic thriller.
Yes, it's right? A romantic thriller. The way I would explain it is, and it's an American soldier, ex-military, backpacking through South America, ends up in Rio, and has a high adventure romance with this woman, Natal.
I'm gonna forever be embarrassed that I said Lauren Graham. I am so sorry. I can't believe that just came out of my mouth.
Not to mention, she's sitting right
there. I'm like, this is just the worst. It's because I'm sitting next to Chad Michael Murray, and I'm sorry, I'm nervous here. Okay, let's see. So, have you seen Harry Potter?
I'm pretty sure I've seen and know Harry.
Okay, good, good. What is your favorite Harry Potter character?
Ooh, that's a good one. I mean, if you say Voldemort, does that make it weird?
No, Voldemort's a great character. I mean, he's evil, but like.
There's something really fascinating about him. There really is. I don't know, for anyone who loves, you know, playing
with evil
really,
characters.
Really, really evil, like, crazy character, because you have a freedom to do something that you can't do with someone with a moral compass. You get the freedom to kind of play and do whatever. But I always loved Harry. I loved their relationship. I loved his relationship with Rupert Grint, who happens to be my birthday partner. We should say birthday. Just throwing that out there.
So if there was a remake of Harry Potter and you could play whoever you want, doesn't matter how old, who would you want to play?
Oh man, I want to be one of the Weasleys.
One of the Weasleys? So like, not run.
Well, I mean, I don't know. Well, any of the Weasleys, because they just were so all over the place. They were characters, and that was what was great about it.
The twins?
kind of, yeah, because I would like to play both of them.
Yeah, like the Parent Trap. Yeah. Do you know what Hogwarts house you are?
No, I don't.
You know the houses, though, right?
Slytherin. Probably a Slytherin.
Because I used Voldemort to be. Now my favorite character.
Now I've kind of moved on, though.
Do you want me to tell you, like, about the other ones?
Yes, please.
Okay, Hufflepuffs are, like, really good at finding things. They're super loyal.
Correct.
Then you got the Gryffindors, who are brave. They're kind of, like, overly brave. Like, they're really confident in themselves, but sometimes it's like you gotta take a step back because you're
she
being
said
obnoxious.
They were stupid.
I know. And
overly
then,
brave.
sometimes. And then the other Ravenclaws are smart and weird and quirky.
Oh man, that's tough. But,
yeah.
Gryffindor.
Okay. So you think you're like overly brave sometimes?
Yeah.
Okay.
The stupid part is what got me.
Cool. What, do you have a favorite episode of Gilmore Girls?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
So there's one where I get in a fight with Dean.
Yes.
And his comeback, well, might have been one of the worst comebacks in the history of mankind. He, like, called me Dristan, which is like a nasal cream, because it rhymed with Tristan. I remember.
He doesn't have the best comebacks in general.
Oh, my God, it was brutal. And the poor guy, we had been picking on that line all day. But I loved working with Jared. I mean, Jared and I are still buddies, and, you know, now we get like our kids and we're grown up. And, well, a little bit, not completely grown up. I don't know if you've met Jared, but if you do, you know. He's a big kid, and I love him.
If you could go back to Gilmore Girls and play any of the other characters, who would you want to play?
Ooh.
Lorelai?
Well, at this point, man, I could make a great Lorelai,
you
right?
could make a great Lorelai,
right?
It would work.
I mean, I don't know if I can speak that fast anymore. But,
Everyone on Gilmore Girls has to speak fast.
Oh, that was it. There was no time for pauses. That was the first thing they told us. Okay, there's no beats. Just read. Oh, okay, cool. Brrr. It's great.
Have you seen The Hunger Games?
Of course.
Okay, who would you want to play in The Hunger Games remake?
Oh man, there's so many great characters. Who's the guy?
Peter.
I think it's in the second one. Comes in.
Finnick.
Caesar.
Finnick.
You would want to play Finnick. Yeah. I think you'd slip right into that role there.
I liked him because he kind of went against the grain.
He
gave himself up for the greater good.
Twilight. Have you seen Twilight? Do you know Twilight?
I know.
Do you know anything about Twilight?
I know of Twilight.
What are your feelings about Twilight?
My feelings about Twilight. I thought it was well lit.
Oh, okay.
The cinematography.
Wow.
Did a great job.
So if you were forced to be in Twilight, would you want to be like a rock? Like,
I've never seen the film, so I can't speak to it.
If you were forced to Freaky Friday with somebody.
Who
would you want to be forced to Freaky Friday with?
Well, see, like, there's like, pipe dreams, you know?
Yeah, pipe dream Freaky Fridays work.
You know, you can jump back, like, 10 years. Like, Brett Favre at his peak, like, that'd be fun for a little while, right? To just, like, okay, cool, I'm going to go out on Sunday and play football.
Oh,
you
yeah.
Know, I'm not like, really supposed Brett to be playing football. It's okay. It's cool. He's an athlete. And,
cool.
Played for the Green Bay Packers.
Oh, okay, nice. So you do professional football.
Yeah, professional football.
That'd be cool.
But I kind of thinking, like, you know, we could do it. You know. We could
a Freaky Friday?
Yeah.
Oh my god, that'd be crazy.
Right?
That'd be crazy. Be Chad Michael Murray for a day?
Yeah. It'd be crazy. I get to see what's going on in there. You can see what's going on in there.
Oh yeah. Do you have a favorite book movie adaptation?
I mean, I just recently saw 1984. That was incredible. But I mean, there's so many, you know, you like.
Yeah, I always say Catching Fire because that was like a perfect adaptation.
Ooh.
Yeah.
You know what's funny? I'm still a fan of the original Hunger Games. Hunger Games, the original.
The first one?
And I did, by the way, don't tell anybody, I did read the first book.
Oh, good.
Did.
And once don't I got tell anybody. Say it loud and proud.
I read the first book. Well, because, like, my favorite books, right, aren't what you would stereotypically assume from someone who is, you know.
Yeah.
Like me, my favorite book growing up was Jurassic Park. I love Jurassic Park, right?
That's great.
And then, well, yes, but like I'm supposed to have the answers, you know, the 1984s or the Brave New World,
no,
or
just like the classics,
or you know, any of those great books, and they're fantastic.
Yeah,
and they are,
of course.
And they really affect
you're
me. Catcher in the Rye, man,
stuff.
Rocked my world the first time I read it. Right? I mean, who didn't think they were in that book?
I was kind of annoyed by that guy.
I get it.
He was constantly complaining, but yeah, I see your point of view.
But I think so was I at 17. I think I was like, God. I'm holding.
Is there a show that you're currently binging right now?
Stranger Things.
Nice.
Holy cow.
Season one or two?
I just started.
Oh, shit.
I know. Yeah. I'm six in.
Okay.
My wife jumped ahead because I was filming that Savannah.
And
she finished. Yeah. So I did get to see, you know, Eleven gets hair. And that drove me nuts. I'm like, But I get it. I get it as an actress, like, shaving your head for multi years.
Yeah,
like,
rough. Yeah. Chad's book is out now. Chad and Heather Graham. It is American Drifter. Go get it. It's in stores now. It's very exciting. Thank you so much for joining me for these questions.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
She has the best energy in the world. Seriously, you gotta be around. It's palpable.
I'm Christine.
I'm Chad.
I'll see you next time. Goodbye. I'm sweating right now. I haven't even edited it. I'm just picturing myself finishing editing it and then showing you guys, and you just saw it. I encourage you to face a stupid fear of yours today and let it go. I'm Christine. I make videos every Tuesday. I'm also active on Twitter and Instagram. I'll see you next time. Goodbye!